Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In today's video, I am going to explain you what is voltage distribution along the string of suspension insulator. And also in next video, I will explain you about the string efficiency and the methods to improve the string efficiency. And also I will recommend you to please watch my previous video, which is based on insulator and types of insulator, so that you can understand the concept of insulators and what is mean by suspension insulator. Okay, so let's start. A suspension type of string insulator consists of number of porcelain discs connected in series through metallic links, and suspension insulator are widely used in electrical overhead transmission system. I will show you a diagram of suspension type insulator. Okay, see, this is a diagram of suspension type insulator. There are three discs connected, so the name is three disc string insulator. In between these discs, a metal link is present, and due to this metal link, a capacitance is created between the two discs. So in between two discs, between each two discs, a capacitance is created, and this capacitance is known as self-capacitance or mutual capacitance. Also, a capacitance is created in air between the tower and conductor, and this capacitance is known as the shunt capacitance, as you can see in this equivalent diagram. Okay, so this figure shows a three disc insulator, and this is the equivalent circuit of this three disc string insulator type. If there were only self or mutual capacitance, means if there were only these capacitance and these shunt capacitance were not present, then the charging current would have been the same through all the disc. It means if these shunt capacitance were not present, then the charging current would have been same through this disc. Okay, the voltage would have been uniformly distributed across the string, and the voltage across each disc would have been the same. But due to the shunt capacitance, charging current is not same, it is divided. You can see over here, this current is divided into shunt and self capacitance. So from above equivalent circuit, we can apply Kirchhoff's law over here. We are taking three nodes over here, A, B and C, and we can apply the Kirchhoff's law to find the current through these capacitance. Okay, see, now consider this node A. So for node A, I2, which is equal to capital I1 plus small I1. Okay, now XC is the reactance of capacitor, which is equal to 1 by omega C. Now we are considering capacitance, so XC is equal to 1 by omega C. And in place of resistance, we are using these capacitive reactance. So we know this formula, V is equal to IR and I is equal to V by R. So I will be V into omega C. See, by using this equation, I will be V into omega C. Now let's equivalent V2 into omega C, which is equal to V1 into omega C plus V1 into omega KC. Now see this over here, we are taking C1 as KC, because these shunt capacitance are a part of these self capacitance only. So we are assuming that shunt capacitance, that is equal to K into C. So all this shunt capacitance will be K into C. So omega C gets cancelled, V2 is equal to V1 into 1 plus K. This is equation 1. Now for node B, okay, for node B, see over here, node B, I3 is equal to I2 plus small I2. So V3 into omega C, which is equal to V2 into omega C. Now this I2 will be V1 plus V2. So I2 will be V1 plus V2 into omega KC. So V3 is equal to V2 plus V1 K plus V2 into K. Omega C gets cancelled. So the equation becomes V1 K plus V2 common 1 plus K, which is equal to V1 K. We can write this V2 is equal to V1 plus K over here. So V2 is equal to V1 into 1 plus K into 1 plus K, which becomes V1 into 1 plus K square over here, V1 into K, V3. So this becomes V1 common K plus 1 plus K the whole square. Okay. So on next page, so the remaining equation I will write over here. Okay. V3 is equal to V1 into K plus 1 plus K the whole square, right? Which will become V1 into 1 plus, sorry, 3k plus k square. This I have equivalent as a plus b the whole square, which is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. Okay. Now this becomes the equation 2. V3 is equal to V1 into 1 plus 3k plus k square. Now, voltage between the conductor and a tower is, we know, see, the voltage between the conductor is over here, and the earth tower is capital V, which will be equal to V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. So, equating in this equation, V1 is V1 plus V2 is V1 into 1 plus K by equation 1. Then V3 is V1 into 1 plus 3K plus, sorry, K square by this equation. So it becomes V1 into 3 plus 4K plus K square. If you solve this equation, you will get 3 plus 4K plus K square. This is equation 3. So capital V is equal to V1 plus 3 plus 4K plus K square. Okay, so now from equation 1, 2 and 3, we can say that voltage across, okay, see over here, from equation 1, 2 and 3, voltage across the top disc over here, voltage across the top disc is minimum, while the voltage across the disc nearest to the conductor, the voltage across the disc nearest to the conductor is maximum, that is, which is V3 is equal to V1 plus 1 plus 3K. V3 is equal to, V3 is equal to V1 into 1 plus 3K plus K square. So we can say the voltage drop nearest to the conductor is maximum, that is V3 is equal to V1 into 1 plus 3K plus K square, and the voltage across the top disc is minimum. So this is the conclusion, and due to this non-uniform voltage distribution across the string, the unit nearest to the conductor is under maximum electrical stress and is likely to be punctured. So this is the conclusion for the voltage across the three disc, okay? voltage distribution along the string of suspension insulator. So these are the equation V1, V2, V3, and we can conclude that the voltage or the disc nearest to the conductor means this disc is under maximum stress. And in next video, I will also explain you about string efficiency, which is related to this only. So if you like my video, please like and subscribe my channel and also click on the bell icon. Thank you for watching my video.